Hello everyone, it is Joe here from OmniPoke, the channel that brings you guys everything Pokemon. Today we're looking at the Snuggly Raichu deck. It's an archetype that tries to get a bunch of energies into play using Raichu's powerful Spark attack to do big one-hit knockouts with this guy. And all thanks to this little promo Pikachu that we now have that has the Nuzzle attack. It means that we can have this little mini engine going on here. Pachirisu getting energies into play. Amolga helping us search out early basics and our engine in the first place, whilst also being a free retreater. So the idea is pretty simple. Flood the board with yellow energies and hope that that gives you enough damage to knock things out. That is the intention of the deck. So let's jump straight into it. First of all, we do have the SM162 promo of Pikachu. It's essential that it's this basic because this is the only Pikachu in standard that has the Nuzzle attack. And we literally need it to say the word Nuzzle on it. Obviously, the effect of the attack is fine. We can paralyze if we are stuck with nothing else to do. But the fact that it says the word Nuzzle is huge because that synergizes with Amolga, means this is very searchable throughout the game. And it synergizes with the Snuggly Generator attack as well. So that is the entire base of the deck. This promo has opened the door for this deck to become a thing. Then we have our main attacker, Raichu GX. 210 hit point lightning type stage 1 Pokemon. Has that super awkward weakness to fighting, which is a real shame. It does have a resistance to metal as well, but the powerful Spark attack is essentially the same as Darkrai's Dark Pulse from way back when on an EX, but for lightning energies. So it does 20 plus 20 for each of the lightning energy attached to your Pokemon. So the idea is flood the board of energies wherever you want them, just have them in general, and you're doing 20 plus 20 more for each in play. So we're going to use EXP shares to retain these in play. We have the Coco Prism Star to get energies back from the discard pile, and we have the early turn acceleration from Pachirisu as well. So that is the entire idea. He does come with two other attacks, Thunder for two lightning and a colorless does 160, and you do 30 to yourself. This can be a nice Hail Mary if you haven't had the time to use your Pachirisu, or if you just need to finish off something like a Tapu Lele GX, you can Choice Band and Thunder, and you're probably going to take the last couple prizes. So bear in mind, as your board starts to deplete of energy, in like the late game, you still have Thunder to fall back on. We also have the Volt Tail GX attack that does 120 and paralyzes the opponent's active. Again, Hail Mary plays. If your opponent doesn't have a large hand size, you can go for a paralysis and hope to two-shot something. But it's something to bear in mind, similar to Lapras' GX attack, really, in many ways. From there, we have the little engine of Snuggles. So Pachirisu has the energy accelerating attack. For each of your bench Pokemon that has the Nuzzle attack, search your deck for lightning energy and attach it to that Pokemon, then shuffle your deck. So the idea is Amolga has Nuzzle, Pikachu has Nuzzle, this has Nuzzle. We can attach, you know, sometimes 3-4 energy cards turn one just from one attachment on the Snuggly Generator. And that's going to set up not only our attackers for the whole game, but our damage output. That's the idea. And another great thing is Pachirisu also has the Nuzzle attack. So it's searchable via the Amolga's Nuzzly Gathering ability. So that's a really cool thing as well for the card overall. Here is the Amolga. It is our free retreater, which is always good. So it's an optimal lead. So with three of this guy and three Pachirisu, we have six optimal leads in the deck. This guy also has Nuzzle, so you can use Amolga's own ability to find him. And that simply says you may search your deck for a Pokemon that has the Nuzzle attack, reveal it, and put it into your hand each turn. So this gives us a little bit of extra, not really draw power, but it does tutor out cards from our deck to thin it. So at the very least, we can't have these sort of dead draws in the mid game. And also has great synergy with Pokemon Communication, which we play a high count of, as well as in general finding that early Pachirisu or finding early basics with Pikachu. These nest balls are not only one Amolga, it's an Amolga plus a Pikachu or plus a Pachirisu. So immense value in the early turns here for making us flood our bench early, which is very, very cool. Amolga giving us some extra value, making our Ultra Balls a little bit cheaper throughout the game. And our Pokemon Communications always live, essentially, is the idea here. And as I mentioned, it has free retreat, so it's a perfect start because we can pivot straight into Pachirisu without any questions asked. From there, we're going to have more lightning support. The Tapu Koko Prism Star gives us even more energy acceleration from the discard pile. And we are going to have the Tapu Koko GX. Tapu Thunder is just such a powerful GX attack to have right now, especially when Raichu isn't all that strong on his own. Having Tapu Thunder as an option is great. It's going to be very powerful at taking one-shots, especially against the likes of Pikachu and Zekrom Tag Team GX. That deck is going to be swarm the energy onto the field at one point or another. and we can try and punish them with the Tapu Koko, because reaching 240 isn't the easiest, at least in the early game. And if they're playing the like early Zapdos package, they're going to have early pressure. They'll be removing energy from the board whilst taking prizes. So we can't just sit there and snuggle until we've got enough for 240 damage. We're going to have to use the Tapu Thunder GX attack to get us over the line. From there, I have incorporated a small package of Muk. I think when we have 3 Pokemon Communication and 3 Nespal, as well as 4 Ultra Ball, we have reasonable odds of getting early Ditto Grimer down against the Zapdos players. It's just one of those things where if you are a GX deck right now, there's not many other ways you can come back into the game against the Zapdos variant other than just tanking hits and maybe playing Acerola. I don't think this deck has enough draw power to play Acerola or space particularly, so I'm preferring the Muk line. So Ditto, of course, doesn't have the Snuggle attack, which is a shame, but it can evolve into a Raichu at the very least. And we have the Alolan Grimer. Take your pick of which Grimer you want. I mean, we don't play DCE, so the other two attacks aren't that relevant on the Dark ones. But this one at least has a 3 attack cost, which can poison. So that's why I've gone for this one. They all have a 3 retreat cost as well, which is annoying. And Alolan Muk, obviously, Power of Alchemy shutting off each basic Pokemon in play, hand, and discard pile. Shutting off those abilities. Small anti-synergy with your own Emolgas. But really, Emolga's a better early game card than it is like required throughout the mid and late game. And it's going to be so important for us to shut off Jirachi to stop Zapdos chaining knockouts and stopping them reach with electro powers and all that good stuff. So Muk is pretty much in here exactly for the Zapdos decks. It can also slow down some Malamar builds as well if they're also Jirachi focused. And bear in mind, they can easily be playing their Marshadow GX as well for type coverage. So shutting those things off is going to be important. Obviously, there's a big downside to putting in play any of these Pokemon that don't have the word Nuzzle on them, because it means we're getting less energy acceleration. But against Zapdos, we hit them for weakness anyway, because we're Lightning type, so we really might not even need a Snuggly Generator in that matchup at all. We might get away with just an early Dance of the Ancients and just manually attach throughout the game. So I think Muk gets away with it in this deck, for the matchups that we're trying to target at the very least. Finally, one copy of Tapu Lele GX. Again, doesn't have the Nuzzle attack, which is a shame, but it will get us into a turn one supporter card, so that's pretty good. And we have 3 Calm, 4 Ultra Ball, reasonable outs of getting this into play, which is pretty cool. Onto the item cards, it's all about getting our Pokemon out, because we're so efficient at getting energies into play as long as we've hit early Pokemon on the board. So we're going to have Run Stretcher to recycle our dudes. 3 Pokecom, obviously amazing synergy with the Nuzzly Gathering ability. 3 Nest and 4 Ultra to just get as much into play as possible. Obviously, Ultra Ball has some small synergy with the Dance of the Ancients as well. Onto the supporter cards, I'm again trying to be just streamlined and simplistic. Throwing in an Erica's Hospitality as an additional supporter to follow on from these 4 Lily and 4 Cynthia. The deck does thin itself quite well. Again, once you've used a Snuggly Generator, the deck is thinned of like sometimes 4 or 5 energy cards. So straight away, you're drawing into a lot less bad cards, which is pretty good for the deck, to be honest. So as long as we can get lots of basics out early, use a Snuggly Generator, the deck is going to thin itself really quickly. So just drawing into more supporters is always going to be good to have a chain going throughout the game, because we have no draw engine in ourselves right now. From there, just 3 copies of Guzma to target the right things at the right times. And then the 4 Cynthia and Lily obviously speak for themselves. A couple copies of Choice Band to increase our damage output is always going to be a big deal, helping us push against GXs for this powerful spark to be... taking one shots, and 3 copies of EXP Share, fulfilling the same role, but also just keeping attackers chaining as well, and keeping energies in play always live for something like an Aero Trail play if we have to as well. So EXP Share, just going to keep damage throughout the whole game and make sure we have a lot of viable attacking options as well. Finally, just 12 Lightning. Seems like a plenty for me. We can snuggle, we can Dance of the Ancients, we can have manual attachments each turn so that even if Raichus are getting knocked out, we're getting EXP shares and we're getting manual attachments and we're straight back to square one with our damage output. So that's pretty much the idea. So yeah, the deck is not as simplistic as it could be. If you want to just cut the Muk package, that's 3 card spaces that you gain. You could just go to 4th Calm, 4th Nest, and 3rd Choice Band. That's where I initially started with this in the beginning of the day. But I have added in the Muk because you basically just can't beat Zapdos otherwise. So yeah, I think if you actually want to respect this deck as a true contender in the format, you have to appreciate that we need to have Muk in here to win, you know, a pretty big matchup in the game right now. And it also helps out against Malamar as well, so something to bear in mind. In terms of Pokemon, I wouldn't really think about anything else. Potentially Zebstrika, just because we're playing Ditto. as like a one Zebstriker, but that's really about it. Basically, anything on your board that doesn't say Nuzzle is a problem for you sometimes. So you don't want to kit out the deck with techs in the Pokemon aspect. In terms of item cards, again, I would just love to increase these counts of Calm and Nespel, because the deck is just so much stronger if you get your basics into play. For item cards, just an extra choice band, extra energy is never too bad. For me, the biggest point of contention is that I don't play any stadium card. Thunder Mountain is always going to be one that you can bear in mind. Right now, I'm still worried about Zapdos, and I'm worried about Pikachu. Giving them, you know, putting this into play against those two decks is like a big no-no, because it's just freebies for them. So I didn't really like the idea of that. Wondrous Labyrinth was one that I was thinking about to, again, help you out a little bit against Zapdos and help you out against, like, the Lost Marches and a few other one-attachment decks, even Zoroark to an extent. My biggest quandary with this card in the deck is that you end up having to commit a third energy to your own Raichu. Sometimes that's difficult in the initial phases of the game. And it's also, you know, if it gets knocked out, it's 60 damage that gets removed from your board rather than 40. You know, worst case scenario, as long as you don't have EXP shares in play. So I'm not a huge fan of the Wondrous Labyrinth, but it can be an additional defense against some early aggressive decks. And the other stadium I would consider in here is Viridian Forest. Again, I think it can benefit Pikaroms and it can benefit Malamars. So I'm not hugely keen on playing the stadium overall. So right now we're foregoing any stadium, no counter stadium. I think the big, like, Shrine is mainly played in Zapdos decks, and the bigger way to tech for Zapdos is by having the Muk. So I'm committing spaces there rather than having an answer for Shrine, but Shrine is still definitely going to be awkward. And if they find, you know, they're one or two copies early, it's going to be pretty bad for you. So I think the deck is not a top tier archetype. I will stress that, but it's fun and it's actually quite simple for a rogue. Because, you know, getting lots of energy into play is pretty easy to do with this deck. And obviously I've got previous experience with the likes of Xerneas Break, a deck that just likes to flood the field of energy and swing. So this is a nice little throwback, being a yellow Xerneas, basically. So it's been fun to test out this deck. One other thing you could consider, actually, is having some switching cards, because although we have six optimal leads, when you don't start a Pachirisu or a Emolga, it's actually a little bit awkward because we have to pay retreat sometimes, or we have to forego the Snuggly Generator, depending on what we face. If we see some Zapdos, it means we don't need to use Pachirisu at all. We will Pokecom this guy away, and we're going to go ahead and grab an Emolga, because Emolga guarantees us a Pikachu as well. It is going to be a priority to get Grimer and Ditto down, but before we do that, we don't just want to lose because he kills our only Pikachu. So let's grab Pikachu, attach to the active EXP share the bench, and just fire off a Lily here. That can go there, this can go here, this can happen. Ultra Ball will be a big hit, Nespel's not too bad. This can at the very least get us Ditto. I don't think decks are necessarily expecting us to play Muk in here, so that's also a small thing that we have going for us. People won't really expect it coming. But our hand is pretty terrible outside of this, so let's pass. As I said, once you've thinned those energies, this deck is pretty clean. Until then, life is pretty scary, and this opening hand is abysmal. So Zapdos is one of those decks that will keep you honest and take a prize a turn, more than likely. Our opponent straight away is going to actually let loose. Interesting. So they're probably, I imagine it's a Pikarom with Zapdos rather than just a straight Zapdos Jirachi. We get a better hand somehow from this, which is insane. And our opponent actually just passes. Well, we're going to Nuzzly Gathering. Just pick up an Emolga to our hand. We're going to evolve the active. If there was a Zapdos active, we could actually knock it out, which is quite fun. We're going to put down an Alolan Grimer. Just give them something else to deal with that's not our active, basically. And just swing for 60. We had the option of retreating and snuggling, but because we hit Zapdos for weakness anyway, I like just putting this pressure on. I mean, it's more sort of, I mean, it's not too much pressure on the Prism Star, but it's more just having the attack ready to go. Like, we would retreat, get like two more energies in play, then have to retreat again, or give him an easy one prize. So this way he has to find a Guzma rather than just like be content to retreat and hit for 80. Pretty much the idea. And we really don't need damage in this matchup. Until we start seeing Pika ROMs. Let's see if they are just going to retreat and smack us. Ah, they do have a Guzma, so they've been debating what to Guzma up by the looks of things. They are just going to go for the Grimer. Obviously, it's a big threat. They're going to go for Stellar Wish as well. Grab himself a Volkner, possibly for next turn. And they actually can't move this Grimer. And we Hyrule. Holy. Okay. Let's keep pulling cards out of our deck. Let's do this. I do want to keep attaching. It's just putting it on a Pikachu is a little bit awkward. Putting on Ditto is like the same as putting on a Grimer, really. So I guess we just put it here. No. Awkward decision. Awkward decision because we're not drawing cards at the moment. I mean, we don't need the damage, right? Yeah, we don't need the damage. We'll just get out of this dead hand immediately. No, didn't happen. So we know our opponent has Volkner right now. The thing they were missing last turn was a switching card. So now they've got to reload a Zapdos and find a switching card. It's probably why they're using Stellar Wish first, because it means if they find a Ball Search or a Stretcher, they can then Volkner for the switch card, or other way around if they find the switch card. Whereas if they Volkner first, they have to like half their outs, basically. So then picking up Nest Ball means at the very least they'll be smacking our active with Zapdos here. At the very least. Ah, they could be getting out the Jolteon as well. That's also a thing. Let's see what our opponent wants to do here. Looks like they're debating on Volkner or a Guzma, but they're just going to use Dance of the Ancients. It's a big ask for them to hit 210. I'd like to say impossible, but it's not impossible. But a Swift Run is still strong here. Or like a Headbolt's fine as well. He has a lot of good options. Oh, he's going to keep electro-bulleting, hoping that we are bricking. Fair enough. You got me. We're bricking, all right. No doubt about it. Well, we get a cheeky bit of poison on. At least. At least we got that going for us. His Jolteon with an Electro Power here can be taking two prizes though, which is super scary. A lot of value. He's actually going to go for a switch. Interesting. Maybe he's already holding on to the Electro Power and he can just retreat Stellar Wish and switch. Doesn't want to get too much damage from this poison, I guess. The 10 damage means that we can thunder, though. Give him the big thunder. Thunder tails. They pick up another Guzma. Can't imagine they'd... Yeah, they're still going to play Switch here. There is the Electro Power. So I'm assuming it's going to be a two-prize knockout. Yep. There goes our hopes of Muk. But it has been a good distraction. They've played like two Guzmas rather than getting lots of supporting supporters. Not draw supporters, not supporting supporters. What am I talking about? Oh, Rescue Stretcher. Interesting. Let's keep thinning our deck. Try and get rid of some of these dead draws. Thunder him for his ignorance. Jump over a potential Buzzwole turn as well, which is nice in case he was going to be rainbow based. And we do pick up a supporter. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. We do get the benefit of playing greedy in this matchup. Especially when this has already been played. We don't have to be concerned about a opposing Tapu Koko just coming in out of nowhere. You need to start accumulating a lot of Electro Powers to get a knockout here. I'm going to see Stellawish for a Volkner again. Skateboard onto the active. Retreating into another Stellawish. Looks like they're definitely digging for goods here. They pick up a Nespel, so now that they can Nespel, Zapdos, Volkner for Switch Card Energy. Hit us for 80, at the very least. That's what I'm hoping happens. Much more scary things could be happening. But this little purple distraction has been great so far. Oh, they are the thick Jolteon build by the looks of things. Yep. Next Jolteon's on the way. They're trying to trap us again? Yeah, okay. Fair enough. We're gonna try and poison him again then, I guess. Worked last time, right? We're going to grab Muk here. It means it's going to be hard of him to Electro Bullet for two prizes. Even though this Muk is probably just going down, it means he can't take the two prizes. Well, he has to find two Electro Powers now. And with Jirachi shut off, it should be harder, in theory. If he can Volkner for a second Electro Power, though, we will be in a bit of discomfort here. Even a Swift Run GX would be awkward for us as well. Looks like he's grabbing Stretcher though. So he may be giving it the old slow burn. Attach the active, so I'm imagining there's a Swift Run coming our way. Oh wow. Interesting. They're going greedy. I'd love to punish it with a Guzma. I'd love it. I'd love to punish that greed. My goodness. But alas. Currently, we cannot. Let's pass. So we're certainly in a losing position now that we've essentially lost two more turns. Hopefully, because his Geraitis are shut off for now, though, he just swift runs this turn. We Guzma take a knockout with this one rather than this one. And then it's hard for him to accumulate another Guzma when three have already gone and a bunch of Electro Powers all at once. That's the hope. Oh, he's actually going to commit Electro Power now. I think that's actually worse for him. Going to see an Ultra Ball nonetheless. More Jirachi. Seems good. Aha, I see the problem. The problem is he's going to try and Tapu Koko us for game next turn, and I can't really stop that. Can I? Can I stop it? I could pay retreat with this, and then we have 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 still. No. He's too efficient at retreating. Damn. That's a problem. How do I go about this? When we know we have to Guzma anyway. Yeah, I think we just... I mean, I don't like saying it, but we have to accept that Tapu... Oh no, he's already GX'd. What am I talking about? We're not scared about Tapu Koko. Yeah, this is fine. Why am I scared about Tapu Koko? Let's just try and spark him out and hope that he can't reach 180 on our bench guy. Three Guzmans, one Electro Power gone. Choice Band to 140, Electro Power to 170. So he needs two Electro Power and Band, or three Electro Power plus Guzma. Or Coco GX comes in for him and he needs less buffs. That's also an option. He just got rid of a choice band though, which is suspicious. Very suspicious. So you're telling me he's holding on to all the damage buffs in the world already? That could be scary. Maybe he's holding on to two choice bands and he needs to push to find another electro power. Which he just has. It's probably game then. If they dug out one of their last Electro Power, well, not one of their last, the third electro power that they needed. 130, 160, 190, 210, 220. Well played. Well, for as long as we bricked, that was a pretty close game, to be fair to us. And him trapping that muck was way too... He was like super greedy, but just never punished for it, so fair enough. Only really got away with it as to how poorly we were drawing. Let's get into another game. It's a shame that we couldn't demonstrate the power of muck against his deck. Let's calm. We once again haven't started one of our six optimals, which is a shame. And we're once again staring down a Jirachi, so trying to find muck is going to be good here once we establish the Pikachu. Good turn one, once again. This deck is very efficient at getting lots of basics down. That's one of its benefits. The amount of search we have is high, and we actually have supporters to fall back on this time as well. You can see Ultra Ball getting rid of a lightning, well, two lightnings, and the dream. That's what we want to do for this guy. But at least they've played Volkner. That's something that's good for us. Looks like they're a Pika ROM. They're going to let loose. Another game where we got let loose turn one. This time we appreciate it a lot more, but still. This is a workable hand. See, energy, they still can Stella-wish. It's a matchup like this where it's kind of awkward that we can only snuggle two targets. We might get knocked out on turn one as well if they have an E-switch. That gets rid of a lot of our burst damage. Okay, not quite. I think we have to be content with not attacking this turn. It's pretty ugly. See where that gets us. The reason I didn't attach turn one to Pachirisu was I was expecting him to be Zapdos based and to take a turn one prize. So it looks bad when it turns out he's Pika wrong. Hopefully his low hand size and shutting off Stellar Wish is gonna hurt him a little bit though. But we are going to need some time here to snuggle our way back into a good amount of damage. See an escape rope. Well, Muck's coming up then. This means that if he does commit a bunch of energies, we could try and get our Tapu Koko GX out on him. Oh my. This could be insane if we could get Tapu Koko GX. Insane. Hello there. Pretty good value. Take the Muck, I dare you. And then just pow. The ultimate debate. Unfortunately, Tapu Koko only has 170, and it's not out of the realms of possibility that this Zapdos still comes in and responds. And that's gonna be bad for us, because then we'll be back level on prize trade, and it could get quite scary. Because I need to spend another turn snuggling my way back into an amount of energy that helps. Actually, no, with the EXP share, I could still just respond on the Zapdos. Maybe we're fine. Maybe we're over the hump. Maybe. And if we can tank a hit, we're feeling pretty reasonable about this game. Yeah, I think if we tank, we definitely win. Never say definite, but definite. I'm gonna see a Guzma, okay. Oh God. Oh, I wasn't ready for more electro power shenanigans. Stressing me out. Okay, let's start thinning this deck. It's really interesting how we started muck this game and then basically baited it. That's pretty funny. Uh-oh. Here comes another lost condition. If you can swift run this turn. Oh, no, he's attaching to Zapdos. Okay. I mean, in this case, we are holding Lele this time, so we have Guzma. They're going to pick up Erika's, which is going to get insane value from this deck. He's kind of free to bench this Pikarom. Going to see an Electro Power, which gets him the knockout. They can then Erika. Yep. Yep, Thunder Assault. We're just going to pull some more stuff out of the deck. Play around potential second Marshadow. With his own Coco GX already popped, I think it's a lot to ask for him to tag bolt this turn. For the full value. And with two EXP shares on board, as long as we don't get Field Blowered, we can probably knock out the Jirachi or the Marshadow to close the game. We see Attach, Choice Band, Electro Power. So they're looking for Eastwich Stadium. That's Eastwich. Maybe it's already there for them. That lets them full blitz again. Ah, here's the Stellar Wish. Gonna grab Volkner. There's the stadium, as expected. But we've been holding this Lele for this opportune moment. Nice. A win against Pikarom. Who knew? Who knew it was possible? Give him the thunder. Nice. A reasonable win. Coco definitely the MVP. Still a great answer to Pikarom. Confirmed. Let's get one more game in. So far it's been lightning on lightning this whole time. Let's see if we can take on anything else. Obviously we don't really appreciate all the fighting support that's in Zoroark decks and just Buzzwole in Zapdos and all that stuff. Oh, looks like we've got the Zapdos returning. The Zapdos Jolteon. Looks like it's just lightning for days. Zap, zap, zap. We're the only one not playing Electro Power. Who needs it? We snuggle our damage. Oh, we started the snug. Yes. The snuggo. Look at him. We get the benefit of a couple of mulligans as well here. Little Snuggums. Oh, no mulligans? Wait, oh, we mulligan twice as well? Or do we both mulligan once? I wasn't even paying attention. Okay, Grimy Ditto is still here. Very good. We're gonna do our normal play. Nuzzle for the nuzzle. Da, da, da. Do the same thing as last time, literally. And look for those basics. That ain't great, I'll be honest with you. Oh, crumbs. I mean, we played 12, so this is an unnatural amount to have in our hand all at once. There are plenty of decks that play more than 12. Even Pikaron plays 11. So a hand like this is just not right, is it? Just not right. Pachirisu has a nice 70 hit points instead of 60 as well, so this is actually our tankiest thing against the Jolteon. Literally. That's me when I draw off a lily right there. That's my opponent as I say pass. Huh? But your hand is so large. Yeah, I know. One single tear. Okay. Has to be a Pikachu. This is weak to lightning, so at least this forces an electro power. Let loose. That's all I'm saying. As an adventure bag, that helps them grab a means of retreating out this Jirachi. As well as like choice band if they just want to get rid of it, or another, maybe just double a skateboard. Yeah, choice band, sure. Pick it up for the sake of increasing damage later. Oh. Absol. Absol means I can't just freely retreat into a Mulga like a happy bunny. And they are going to target said Emolga. Well, it's a threatening card, I guess. I guess. Right. And I hope we have a good amount of energy left in deck for this Snuggly Generator. Otherwise, we'll be telling our opponent a lot of information. We just about have enough. For some reason, it still makes you declare the first three targets, then the last one gets put on automatically. Don't ask me why, it just does. Strange coding on Snuggly Generator. So, would our opponent prioritize knocking out Grimer? Or just attach and head bolt. Or swift run. Honestly, they're all good. They're all good options. Because our hand is just energy. Well, they start with a Volkner, which tells me they're probably just going to swift run through us here. You can reach 190 next turn, realistically. Actually, no, we could... nothing's out of our range, just like in terms of what he thinks, just because we have the potential for Dance of the Ancients as well. Ah, they're going to rope again. That's good for us. Take the Imolga. It was a freebie otherwise. I'm going to pick up Guzma, okay. Is it going to be Swift Run or Head Bolt? Oh, Electro Bullet as well. That works too. Huzzah. Just the fact they attach the second energy. Let's be brave. If stuff goes badly, we can just nuzzle. Well, didn't go badly. Rewarded for bravery. Putting this down protects us from a Coco GX as well. Happy days. They have got Guzma for this muck if they want to, though. They could Guzma Swift Run the muck, and then we're just like, oh, very good. Yeah, he's even going to head bolt. It means he can carry on with the Coco GX attack next turn. Yeah. Yeah, I see you. I see you being clever. Good job. Huh, poggers. Well, that's all our energy. It'd be a shame if he were to tap a Coco GXB. I mean, not this turn. This turn he just announced an attack and pretty much guarantees his win with a hand that size. And Stellar Wish available. Turns out a handful of energy is still just a handful of energy, no matter what deck you're playing. Poor Snuggles. We tried so hard. Nuzzled so far. See an attachment to Absol. You can see he's just setting up for Coco GX. It is pretty clear what's going on here. Even our Pikachu has an EXP share on, so we can't even go for a Thunder Jolt to skew the prize trade. Embarrassing. Well, maybe it's his last prize. Last two prizes, maybe. There's a chance, right? That's our only chance. I mean, we need a lot to go well for us here to not lose immediately. Like, a heck of a lot. Bait with the ditto. Spark him out. Drop the well played. We know what's happening. Hey, nice Raikou coin. Respect. Phew, that was close. Doing 450. Pow. Yep. This deck doesn't play around Tapu Thunder very well either. So that's the deck. It was fun. It's a shame we drew into a heap of energies. Muk kept getting dealt with, but at least it's forcing Guzmans from the opponent and making them draw like suboptimally. That's the intention, at least. Even if it's just a distraction, it's still a helpful card in the deck. We got to have a nice highlight reel against Pikarom, but overall, the Zapdos deck is still a thing, kind of keeping this at bay for sure. And the fact that Tapu Koko is tapped in Zapdos and Pikarom, it's awkward for us as well when we're trying to flood energies everywhere. So definitely some hurdles for this deck, but it's a fun one, and I hope this build is nice and simple for you guys to have some fun games with it, because it's Pikachu after all, so everyone needs to play it at some point in their lives. All right, that's it for today, guys. Hope you did enjoy, and I'll see you guys in another video soon. Cheers.